All right, it's 3:30. I believe it's time to get started. So first of all, I wanted to thank everyone for joining us here for our BFC Green Talks. This is what we're putting on every Thursday. We're very excited about it. I'm particularly very excited about this particular installment, this particular talk. Marina Korten-Busch, who I think many or all of us know, is going to be sharing with us the secrets of chocolate. Marina is the head of the BFC Green Little Enterprises Lifestyle Cluster, so be sure to go over and check that out as well after the session's done here. You can get some great information there. And check out the other clusters too. There's lots of good information out there to just help you live a more enriched life. So without further ado, let's just jump right into this. Here's Marina, and she's going to tell us all about the secrets of chocolate.
Thank you very much, Brian. Thank you very much to everyone who has found time today in the afternoon for this small session and supported our project, BFC Green Talks, and especially this topic, Secrets of Chocolate. And today, I'm going to speak about my experience with making chocolates, and for me, also extremely important. If I buy chocolates or if some ingredients, always to see this symbolic. If you see, for me, it's important to have a draw, like without any termination or like a temperature until 42 degrees. It was very important for me also vegan symbol. It's the chocolate. It's not using animals products. Also, in this symbolic like organic. It's for English products and bio for German products. This is like some certification standards of chocolates or products or chocolates if you are buying in supermarket or really just to pay attention to it. But also about chocolates, one second, I'm going to, yes. So you see, this is the definition about cacao tree and cacao pods, the names which we are using if you speak about chocolates or original products. And for us, it's actually from my experience, I have like I'm using cacao nibs or shelled cacao beans. It's like a chocolate. It's not without any sugar. It's natural. You can just eat it as chocolate already. But not everyone, or especially kids, love it. Because it's like smell like a coffee. Or cafe cacao, it's a little bit no sugar and so on. That's why we thought about how to make your own homemade chocolate. And for this, you need these two pieces, like cacao butter and cacao powder. And actually, these two pieces, they're like parts from cacao beans, and it's special technology to bring the fat, like to separate these two parts from the beans. Yes? To produce the chocolate. And actually, simple way to have just three products to make it at your home or with your friends, you need to have cacao butter. Yes, like this, what I'm using. You need to have cacao pulver. And you see, it's like cacao, they have so many arts and so on. And this is Criollo. It's very special. Really like taste extremely well, and this is and also you need some like instead of sugar, some syrup. It could be Yacon syrup. It's just vegetables which are growing in Switzerland or in the countries like vegetables. But also you can use like agave syrup or maple, like all possible like natural products. You also see the summits like identification non-GMO. It's really like natural and gluten-free. It's like organic is symbolic. It's extremely important for me personal if I choose some products for me, for example, for chocolate. Yes, and you also see if like cacao butter, you also bio cacao butter, just some this is vegan. Yes, it's already like some notification that it's really top premium products. And then what you need to do, you need just to mix them. And with my daughter Mariel, and it's amazing activities for kids, also to prepare own presents and so on. What it should be done, like step one, it's like, it's even kids, they cut the cacao powder, as you see, they cut it. To bring it, step two, they place cacao powder in the bowl, yes, over a pan of hot water and melt gently. Yes, all steps are written here. And actually, for chocolates, it's extremely important that temperature will not higher as 42 degrees. And we cut it because we need like to get it like one fluid. Yes, like to get mixed cacao powder and cacao butter and also the syrup. Like the kids, they need some sweet. Yes, the chocolates, it's all about sweetness, just to put some free spoons of syrups and all mix. And usually it takes, for me as an adult, about 10 minutes or 5 minutes. It's really very easy. Just mix it to get it at one place. And after that, you can put in the forms or molds. We call it chocolate molds and decorate it. This is like very simple. Yes, you see. For kids, for 7 years old kids, it takes 30 minutes to do it. For adults, 5 to 10, and just very simple. You can do it and at every home. Yes? And we have the silicone molds I'm using for these forms, like you have a butterfly or some for trees, for Merry Christmas and so. And you see, this is what we have done 1 week ago. You can also have a form like a chocolate, yes, like to have it like normal chocolate form. And this is usually what we did 1 week ago. You just put it like nuts or dry flowers, very interesting, or just from tea, something like seeds. You just put all together something the kids are extremely, it's the favorite part of the kids to decorate it. And after that, you have to put it for 30 minutes to refrigerator, just to get it like fixed. And after that, it's, you see, it's no conservation needles, or it's very, very simple. That's why usually they say you have to eat it during the best, like at the same time, like next day, so present it. Just really to eat it, and in refrigerator you can keep it for 1 month or 2 months with chocolates, yes. And you can also put it in some box, decorated box. The kid can decorate the box, or you can make it like a very nice present. And at our family, we are trying now to really make a present to our friend, or especially family members, with our homemade chocolate. And it's really surprising for everyone. What's important to know for adults, if you see, okay, it's simple, but we have like two secrets about chocolates. What's important to know, just do not make mistakes. This mistake we did it also last week. No water. Chocolate does not like water. It should be, what we have done, we have cover the top with with a lid, yes, and it came condensed water in this chocolate. And this is absolute, after that you cannot have a crystal of the chocolate. It will be like a pudding or something. It's really amazing if you have just a little bit water, how the quality, really, you cannot see the quality of chocolate, and to the quality of chocolate belong that you can knaps it, like to have crackers, like it should be like really like a glass. You have to hear it, yes. It should be really like knack, yes. This is about what in Switzerland they say, this is about like quality product, yes. And actually it works. If it's no water, it will come. And also it's important, it works also if it's temperature, the second sector. In a professional, like in businesses, shopkeep businesses, they always have to see the temperature, control the temperature. It should be, if it's melt, It's also like the process of slow food process. The temperature should be not high as 42 degrees. And if you arrive it, it's actually all substance will be melt. And after that, you can cool the whole until 28 degrees. And always for kids, it's a great experience, like to always to see what's the temperature and so on. It can really great teamwork would be. And after that, you have again to warm it till 31 degrees. And after that, you can put it in the molds. And this is the process allowed. This is a special chemical process, and this allowed for chocolate to get a special crystal form, which allowed really to have this kinetic effect of chocolate. Yes, this is very interesting. With kids, sometimes they are not using with temperature. Sometimes it depends of age. But in this situation, if you do it until 42 degrees in slow way, you are sure your kids will eat or your friends will eat really vitamins and just raw products. It's like raw quality. That's why we speak about raw quality of the products. And if somebody of you say, oh, it became complicated, that's why I prepared some simple solutions. What could be done if you have no time and so? For simple solutions, even we found out that even in Moldavia, you can find these Vivani chocolates. And this is, it's, you see, it's not the name chocolates, it's the name Couverture. Yes? And this is exactly cacao butter and cacao pulver put in together. And this is exactly like you need only to melt it. You do not need to mix or cut, just to put it melt and to use to put some nuts in this or some dry fruits and then decorate how you like, yes? And again, use it as a present. This is also the photos from what we have done at our home with nuts, yes? And especially in winter, it's like very traditional nuts presents, yes? Shoki nuts or something. You can just, it's additional something very very interesting presence. And you see again, like the symbolic, vegan, bio. And one world that's usually also this company, it's very important that, for example, we do not have cacao plantages, just we are working with some small farmers in Latin America and Africa, and we are trying to really motivate small farming and to get really, for example, not use any pesticide or so. Just it's about also social enterprise. And I think we as a consumer, we can support such kind of businesses, and we have to know these marks, yes, like these products, yes. And even you can, we have also own chocolates. If you have no time and so, but you can also just present a chocolate if you go to some meetings and so on, just, but with this specific symbolic, it means it's a little bit like educational. You know what you're really supporting the farmers, small farmers, that you really think about environmental business. And also, if you see on the picture, it's a strawberry, and we speak about Shoki fondue. You can just use like fresh apple, strawberry, and so on, and it's a great fun for kids or for guests just to have as a dessert. Everybody can pick up their fruits and get like the really first class chocolate. Oh, this is inside. Some people try it, as I know, for some people they try to do like they're buying somewhere like milk chocolate or some chocolate and trying to put in some forms or make a Shoki fondue. It's not this like the quality. You can really really smell and smell the quality if you use the top products, and especially for small farmers and from these certificated companies, it's amazing, amazing different. And what I'm really proud that we have like some kids clubs in Switzerland, and I'm so proud that they really refuse to eat any some cheap chocolates, especially during New Year's. You have always to become for free some cheap chocolates from I don't know which countries. And they say no, because they know about the quality, what it should be really, the quality of the product. And I'm very happy that's why we promotion this project as little enterprises with kids, that they already, the kids starting to learn about quality, how it should be, and just make a choice. Do they like to take it? Do they like to eat it? And So, and the last slides, it's about sources which I used. For me personally, it was like start with this book, Going Rogue. This recipe, which is ideas about this chocolate, very simple ways, I also adapted from this book. And Judith Wignall, also, it was a great experience in USA, start in USA, but at the same time, long tradition Switzerland. It's extremely interesting exchange between these people and these groups. And also, I was trained on special Schoki seminars for professional, like if you really do it, like a professional with chocolates, on one Sunday in Bern by the company Naturkostbar. And I like very much these people because it's very small company. It's about like 15 people, and they make a produce. They make really raw bio quality of chocolates, and they have some farmers in Latin America, and they love to make seminars to speak about it. And if I make some presents, so I have no time to do on my own the chocolate, I'm trying always to make it like presents to support this company in their products. Yes, because I know that's really sustainable and some values in them. Yes, and as you, maybe every one of you know, we have a special platform. It's called BC Green Platform, and we have a Facebook group. But we are trying, if you have some news or ideas, we're trying to share. It's called iShare, and just we are trying also to post the recipes or like ideas what will become or some information about new companies. And so on this platform, make a text, for example, for this it will be show courses, it will be recipe and so, and just I also extremely motivate you to share your experience, maybe like your hobbies or your ideas on this platform. And I believe it's always interesting to learn and new things, and at the same time support some small businesses and support some sustainable lifestyle and enjoy it. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Marina, for the presentation. It's very interesting. Will you post your recipes on iShare, like the ones that you did with Marielle?
Yes, we already posted, I believe we have this, we posted on BC Green, yes, It's already there. This recipe on BC Green, Little Enterprises, you can find it at Green Cuisine, and you can find it on, just let me go maybe to this, what's the BC Green promotion. If you go here, we will post today, I believe it's already posted, presentation, just you see Secrets of Chocolate. The presentation is already here in live classes, and also from Hobby to Masterclass. This is exactly this recipe, what I talk, it's also here. Yes?
Okay, thank you very much, Marina. I would like to try, it's very interesting.
Yes, yes, yes. You see, it's like one recipe what I told, presented today. It's already here. And another one, it's like you can do truffles. Yes, like it's like simple also mix, just without any forms. You do not need, this is like forms. You can just make with your hands like some kugels, yes, or balls. Yes. This is, yes, we do it. And this is more what also Marina, Green Cuisine, we have a Green Cuisine, and I believe Marina, you also, like if you make like search chocolate recipes, you can find it. But I think also we are trying with iShare something, for example, iShare, if you see about Naturkostbar, this website, and so we're posting about this platform, they have a lot of recipes also. Just we are trying on iShare, because it's easier to post like something, companies' names and so. And you can see they have so many recipes. Yes, you can like soups and so. But also in future, we're planning to something, summarize it on our cuisine, Green Cuisine cluster, just to make it like soups or this, like desserts or so. Yes. And this is exactly, I believe, Evelina, we are planning next week, or Michael, if it will be in Moldova. He's preparing to make it in Moldova. Yes, to do it, because it's what's interesting. Michael also was trained, we as a family, we enjoy it, because it's always the question how you enjoy your time together as a family. And for us, this topic, chocolates, yes, make chocolates. It's so enjoyable for everyone. And Michael's now really, yes, and Michael's so professional now in making chocolates and really so inspired. And he wants to do it at the BC office, also with BC kids and also with employees, yes, who is, so also in Moldova and Georgia, and they're preparing these prospects also in several languages, like a card which could be everybody after that can have it for their recipe books. Take it from home. And so something what we want first, like to test it inside of BC. We did it at the inside of family, and we want to test it inside of BC. And maybe in my year, we're planning to do it with our clients or just something, because it's again the question about what's farmers, what's like of agriculture we're supporting. Yes, it's about education also for adults. Yes. And training for taste, yes.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you.
Any other questions?
I actually have a question. Like, just personally, what are some of your favorite things to put in the chocolate? I noticed you had nuts and dried fruits and raspberries. Like, what would you recommend to someone who's just getting started?
So, it's a good question. It's all individual, yes, but for me, it works really. I put you see all, yes, and I like, can you see my screen, or I need to do it? Sorry, just go to this. Just, if you see for me, what I like is like this, yes, if you see some trees, or some, especially this is like a special, like this is part from some concentration tea. Yes, it's like green tea concentration with some seeds. And I found, for example, for kids, they say, wow, horrible. But for adults, I found like it's really just interesting, like you can cut it. Also pepper. I know now tendency, they put some pepper or chili and chocolates. And it's like special. You can so experiment, like what's your favorite but we also trying to develop some kale chocolates. Yes, we have kale as a chip.
Interesting.
And we thought, why not chips with chocolates? I see the tendency more like, it's. I believe you can experimentize, yes?
Yeah.
And also different colors, yes, you can see. I personally love it. I didn't know if it can sell commercial like this, yes. But I see a lot of companies already, like, especially for these big chocolates, not for pralines, but for big chocolates, for these foam chocolates, they are using really, like, mix of beers and so on.
Yeah, I guess my follow-up question would be, are you going to make some to send some to me? Because those all look delicious, and now I'm getting hungry, so...
And what maybe it's also important, if you have it in raw quality, not overheating, and you have it in raw quality, usually if it's like you have just normal milk chocolate, I don't know how we make it, it's a lot of, you know, some chemical stuff to take it for years of as it is, just usually you can eat the whole and still have be hungry. If you have raw coarse chocolate, sometimes it's enough, like one piece, two pieces. You can eat these. You can eat during 1-2 weeks. Just really, you take like one, you enjoy it. You can, and you also receive some energy. Yes, like something you feel it's like a nature. Yes, it's amazing feeling really. So also with salads. Yes, if you eat salads or just you eat like dry kartoffel, potatoes and so on. Yes. It's what my personal experience with is like dishes. And what we also did, we experimentized a lot at our home with raw dishes. And I decided like to make like the plates became smaller, because we do not need to big plates. Yes. Because if it's really good quality, it's not overcooked, you have vitamins, you eat less. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And you have so much power. It's amazing like experience for Thailand, yes.
Sure.
With like trainings and enterprises.
So that's really interesting. I don't want to monopolize everything. Does someone else have a question for Marina?
I'm just curious because like Marina mentioned that Mikhail will be coming to Moldova, and will we have the, I mean, the ingredients? Will Michael bring ingredients or will?
Yes. I already preparing shopping list, Karen. Like we also with this workshop, we already created it and we will have it. I do not know, maybe from participants who is now participants. My question to you, maybe is somebody from you wants to be a leader, like to support Michael and to be like project manager of this project. Yeah.
We can do like as a team building. So if Brian also, like team building for this, I think would be great. So we could even like divide in groups and experiment. So first like have, because again, not everyone participated today, but have short introduction.
Yes.
And after that, just compete, maybe experiment as you said. Yeah, I mean, that's great. I mean, thank you for sharing, Marina.
Yes, and also maybe to this, usually we experiment at the maximum group, it was 4 kids, yes, with us. Just, we think maybe we can do 3 or 4 small groups, yes, just because it's like, really maybe we speak about some project manager from, see who wants to learn it, who make it, and then we need to really organize that we have enough like equipment and enough with cacao butter and cacao pulver. And
exactly.
Usually if you do just with one this, yes, like 80 grams, and so you have about 24 pralines, yes. It's actually, if you have like, I do like in small boxes, like shuki boxes, like 6 or 4 pieces, and you have like after one workshop, you have like 6 presents, yes, for your friends and so on. And I think also tendency to make it not so big, like at the end, like really small pieces, or 2, 3, 4, it could be real, like it's, how to say, you enjoy it more, yes, you see, like every day one. It's something also about consuming slow food, like something what's extremely, how to say, costly, yes.
Exactly. Well, thank you very much, Marina, for sharing your expertise with us on chocolate. I think everyone here is very intrigued to try this out and to make it. Or I know I'm looking forward to when Michael comes next so that you can try making your own chocolates. And I like Colleen's suggestion of doing it in little groups and having a little bit of a competition. See who can get the best one. I think that's fun.
Interesting. Mm-hmm.
We're quickly running out of time here, so I just wanted to wrap things up a little bit. But thank you again for your presentation, and thank you everyone for coming. You made the time to make it to our little talk today. I just want to remind you that next week Marina is also going to be hosting, as you can see on the screen, raw vegan cooking question and answer. So I hope that you're prepared to learn some new techniques for preparing healthy and delicious dishes that will get your mouths watering and make you want to do more and eat more and have better healthy foods. Also, the week after that, on February 23rd, you're also all invited to a very short history of the English language, which is will be presented by yours truly, by me. I'm very excited about that. And as Marina mentioned earlier, be sure to go to check out the iShare Facebook group and feel free to post suggestions, not just about chocolate or foods, but things that you're interested in that you think might be of a benefit to other people. At the same time, be sure to go over to BFC Green, check out the Little Enterprises lifestyle cluster, as well as the other lifestyle clusters there. There's lots of good information out there, and there's more of the information that's constantly coming out, so be sure to check back regularly. Also, if you're interested in hosting a lifestyle cluster of your own, feel free to contact Marina. I know she'd be more than happy to talk with you about getting another lifestyle cluster started. So once again, thank you to everyone, and we will see you next week.